One of the first skills you need to master when you start climbing is how to belay. As the climber ascends and creates slack in the rope, the belayer pulls the slack out of the system so if the climber falls, they don't hit the ground. Belaying is the most important skill in climbing, so make sure both you and your climbing partner know what you're doing. This video shows belaying with a tube-style device. Consult the manufacturer of your device for proper belaying technique if you use an assisted braking device like a gri-gri. We're going to cover how to prepare to belay, performing a safety check, the proper top rope PBUS belay method, and how to lower the climber once they reach the top. If you're already comfortable belaying on top rope and you want to learn how to belay a lead climber, check out our video on lead belaying. While the climber ties into the rope, you need to do two things: close the system and prepare the belay device. Close the system by tying a stopper knot in the free end of the rope. This way, you can't accidentally lower the climber off the end of the rope. Now you can thread the rope through the belay device. Take the brake side of the rope, pinch off a bite, and push it through the tube. You want the rope leading to the climber on top and the brake strand on the bottom. Then clip a locking carabiner through the rope and the cable on the belay device and into your belay loop. Always make sure to lock the beaner. There's a wide range of these tube-style belay devices on the market, but they all work by increasing the friction on the rope. When you pull the brake end down, the rope gets pinched at three points, making it pretty easy to hold it in place without using a whole lot of strength. Once you've tied the rope off and threaded it through your belay device, have the climber inspect your work, then check theirs. Make sure your harnesses are properly tightened or doubled back if yours need to be. All knots are tied correctly and through both of the harness's tie-in points. The rope is clipped into the carabiner, and the carabiner is locked. When you're both satisfied, the climber will ask,
"On belay?"
When you're ready to belay, respond,
"Belay on."
Before the climber gets on the wall, they'll tell you,
"Climbing."
And when you're ready, confirm,
"Climb on."
PBUS stands for pull, brake, under, slide. When used correctly, this method allows you to pull slack out of the system while staying prepared to catch an unexpected fall. One hand should be on the climber side of the rope. This is called the guide hand. And your dominant hand should be on the brake side. This is called the brake hand. The most important thing to remember is always keep your brake hand on the rope. No matter what, your brake hand should never leave the rope. Seriously, never. Okay, as your partner climbs and creates slack in the rope, pull the slack down with your guide hand and through the belay device with your brake hand. Then bring the rope in your brake hand straight down into the brake position. Use your guide hand to grip the rope under your brake hand, then slide your brake hand back up the rope. Keep your hand at least 6 inches away from the belay device so that if the climber falls, your hand doesn't get sucked into the device and make you drop the rope. Then return your guide hand to the climber's side. Repeat as necessary. Pull, brake, under, slide. Pull, brake, under, slide. To keep your motion small and the climber tight on the rope, it's best to pull in less slack more often. It's absolutely essential to pay close attention to the climber. If they think they're about to lose it, they'll call,
"Falling."
Then you need to pull the brake strand down and let your body absorb the weight of the fall. If they shout,
"Tension, Alex,"
pull all the slack through the device, bring your brake hand into position, then lean into the rope, then shout back,
"Gotcha, Pat."
Once the climber gets to the top, they'll ask you to take up the extra slack. Then they'll lean back into a sitting position and shout,
"You can lower."
When you're ready, you'll reply,
"Lowering."
To lower the climber, bring your guide hand under your brake hand. Keep both hands on the rope and let it slowly feed through the belay device until the climber is safely on the ground. They might call for you to speed up, slow down, or stop the descent, or you may need to vary the speed based on the terrain. Once the climber is safely on their feet, they'll tell you,
"Off belay?"
And you'll give plenty of slack and respond,
"Belay off."
To learn more, check out these videos or click here to find an REI class near you.